First of all, sorry for my colored fingers. This is actually because of the Holi festival here in India. Hey guys, this is Abhishek from Technics Media, and today we are going to do a quick unboxing and detailed hands-on overview of Jioni G1 G-Pad. This is a budget smartphone from Jioni, which comes at a price of around 10,000 Indian rupees, and it is a very close competitor to Micromax Canvas 2. If we talk about the device in terms of the overall packaging, here we have the package with us, and if we take a look over the specification, it is a dual SIM phone with 3G and 2G SIM supported. You have a WVGA resolution display, which is a 480 into 800 resolution display, which is little lower as compared to the resolution which we see on Canvas 2. The resolution on Canvas 2 is 480 into 854 pixels. You have 0.3 megapixel, which is a VGA camera on the front side, and the device is capable of doing high definition video recording at 720p. Now the camera which is written over here is at 8 megapixel, but it is not an 8 megapixel camera, but it is a 5 megapixel camera, which is the rear camera on this device. If we talk about the Android version, you have Android Ice Cream Sandwich preloaded on the device, and Jioni have actually said that they will also launch the Jelly Bean version for this device as well. And the CPU is 1 GHz dual core CPU, Cortex A9, same as we see on Canvas. You have 512 MB of RAM, which is again similar to the Micromax A110, and you have 4 GB of internal storage, and we will just show you how much of that is actually available to the user. You have 32 GB maximum memory card expansion slot on this device, so you have assisted GPS on the device. You have gravity sensor, a polymer ion battery, which is 2100 milliampere hour on this device. Here we have the G1 G-Pad from Jioni. It looks pretty good in terms of the overall display. You have the option to go to the lock screen to unlock the device, or go to the camera directly from here. So let's take a quick overview over the hardware and the ports. On the bottom, we have the 3.5mm audio jack. Here we have a hole for the primary mic. You have a nice chrome lining across the edges of the phone. And then you have an 8 megapixel camera over here with LED flash, as you can see. Here we have the power button, the power and sleep key. Here we have the front camera, and here we have the proximity sensors. We have the earpiece. Here we have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. And on this side, we have the volume rocker on the top. Here we have a physical home button with two touch capacitive buttons, the back key and the settings key. We will take a look over the device later on. Let's take a look what we have in the box. So going further inside the box, we have a flip cover which comes for free within the package. Looks good. We do have a screen protection as well, which comes within the package, and you also have some instructions which tells you how to apply the screen protection cover on your phone. You have the warranty card over here, information about their Twitter and Facebook handles. You have a user manual over here, and you have this paper outlet over here, which actually tells you about the service centers of Jioni in different parts of India. They do have a large list of service centers. You have the standard micro USB cable within the package, a standard USB wall charger within the package, and then here you have the earphones. So these earphones are again standard earphones, but these are in-ear headphones. And then you have the mic module over here with a button to pick the calls. You have a little hole here for the mic. Sorry for my color fingers, this is actually because of Holi. And that's it. Now if we start talking about the device, the Jioni G1 G-Pad, this device looks pretty good in terms of the overall build quality, and in my opinion, it is much better than the build which I have seen on Micromax Canvas A110. This one feels much solid in hand, and it gives you a nice grip as well. You have a texturized back cover, which is somewhat glossy but has a matte finish to it, which gives you a nice grip into your hand. If I talk about the weight, this one feels slightly heavier as compared to the weight which I have experienced on A110 while holding it, but it also feels much more rigid as well. About the display of this device, the display size of this device is 5-inch diagonal, which is same as you have seen in Micromax A110 Canvas 2. If I talk about the resolution, it has a 480 into 800 resolution, which is little less than the Canvas 2 resolution, and the screen is capacitive touch screen. And if I talk about the processor, you have the same processor within this device if you compare it with Canvas 2, and the resolution is low, but it looks pretty okay. If I talk about the viewing angles, the viewing angles are not so great, but again they are okay when it comes to this resolution and this display. This is a WVGA display. Let me just show you the Android version on this device. So you have Android Ice Cream Sandwich 4.0.4, and if we compare it with Canvas 2, Canvas 2 also have Android Ice Cream Sandwich. Let me just show you the storage. So the storage on the device is 4GB, and out of 4GB you get around 1GB available, and you have 8GB of micro SD memory card, which comes pre-installed within the device, so you don't have to actually buy a micro SD memory card. Let me just show you the back side of the device by removing the back panel. You have a little indent over here to actually remove the back cover. Now removing the back cover, we have a 8GB micro SD memory card pre-installed on the device. You have the SIM card slot 1, SIM card slot 2 over here, and we have the battery, which is 2100 mAh, but this one is removable as compared to the Dream D1, which is again from Xiaomi, in which the battery is not removable. And here we have the loudspeaker. So this is how the phone dialer looks like, and you do have the option to do a video call as well with any of your contact. You can access the video call feature over here. So we haven't inserted the SIM card into this device, so this feature is not working as of now. Let's take a look over the messaging. This is how the messaging looks like, and you have a Xiaomi logo in the messaging as a background. And if I go and create a new message, this is how the keyboard looks like. The keyboard keys are quite big. Because of the big display size, we did not face any problem while typing on this device. It also works in the landscape mode. It does take a second or more to actually rotate the orientation. In the landscape mode, the keyboard keys become much big to type, so there is no issue at all. And you can also type using voice. This is a typing test. So as you can see, it takes the input with voice as well. And in order to access all the applications which are running in the background, you just need to tap and hold the home button, and then you will see all these applications. You can always kill them and switch in between these applications from here. Now, taking a look over the running applications, we have 512 MB of RAM on this device, and 325 MB is used, whereas 149 MB is free. And if I go back and show you the responsiveness of the phone and the UI, the phone is pretty responsive. It will become more responsive if I install the Nova launcher. So for all those who are using this phone, if you don't like this theme, you can always replace it with the Nova launcher by installing the Nova launcher from the Android marketplace. And talking about the theme, you can always change the theme by tapping on the setting icon and go over here. It will launch the theme skin application, which comes pre-installed on the device. You can also create your own theme, and then you can preview it, as well as you can have these themes. You can select any of these to set as a theme, and you can change the wallpaper as well in these themes, the lock screen, the icon, dial, SMS icons, and all those things. So as well as the widgets as well, which we do have the automatic brightness feature on this device as well. And if I show you the storage, you do have a micro SD memory card which comes pre-installed on the device, and you have 1GB of internal storage. The storage should not be a problem because you have the option to set SD card as the preferred install location, so all the application will get installed on the SD card. You do have the option of doing USB tethering. You can share the internet with USB cable. You can create a Wi-Fi hotspot, as well as you can share the internet using Bluetooth as well on this device. And you also have the Wi-Fi direct feature, which is supported on this device. Let's take a look over the camera UI. Now this is how the camera UI looks like, which is a little bit optimized but again it looks very much similar to the stock camera UI which we see on Android ice cream sandwich devices. And here we have the option to preview the photo which we captured. You can go to the video mode from here. This is the camera shutter key. Here we can toggle to the front camera. The front camera on this device is a VGA camera. So as you can see, as you can figure out from the quality, the back camera on the device is 5 megapixel. You do have all these options to control the timer. You have the option over here to actually control the scene modes, as well as you can control the exposure as well. And this is how you can actually apply different effects while capturing the photo. So let's take a photo with this camera on this device. Does take some time to actually focus. As you can see, it is taking some seconds to focus, and once it is focused, the photo will be captured. And let me just show you this photo right now. So this is how the photo looks like. It has been captured right now in an indoor light. Clarity of the object is pretty good, as you can see. If you don't move the device much while taking the photos, the photo will be pretty good and pretty clear in terms of the object clarity. Now to conclude our detailed overview of this device, we would like to say at the price at this device is coming, which is around 10,000 Indian rupees. It is a nice choice if you want to buy a device which feels very rigid in terms of the overall build quality. Software wise, this device, the default interface of the device is not very responsive, and it is somehow somewhat laggy when it comes to the software. You can actually enhance it by using third party programs like Nova Launcher. So in all, this device is pretty good, and we will come up with a detailed camera review of this device as well as a full review. Do let us know if you have any questions related to this device. If this video helped you, please click the like button. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.